James Lafferty.
What cool stuff happened in season 4? I have the worst memory, I'm sorry.
I'm James Lafferty. I play Nathan Scott on One Tree Hill.
I'm not, like, incredibly comfortable with my body.
And then there's James, the strong but silent type. You know, he's our Cary Grant. He's our graceful old Hollywood. I stand around and I speak when I'm spoken to and I treat women well. And he's just a gentleman, you know? And
I never even took a limo to prom. Is that weird?
No.
You're a down-to-earth guy.
A mean jump shot.
And I look like a magician.
Nathan's doing a magic show.
No!
It's your life!
That's wrong!
But he's so broken by the fact that his dreams were this close.
Right.
And then they just kind of, you know, went away.
I was willing to do anything really to keep playing basketball. Basketball was always like such a focus for me. If it wasn't basketball season, then I would still be shooting out in my front yard because I didn't care. I wanted to get ready for next basketball season.
When my hair is regular, I have a widow's peak or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So I was always Eddie Munster.
Ah.
Like Eddie Munster. That's probably my favorite one.
All right.
Do I think that a winning gets him come back? Yeah, that's a good question. I don't feel that way personally.
Lafferty.
Yes.
It's a radio interview. I forgot I had it, but it was on my hotel room. I want to call you, you better answer. Okay, I love you.
I held my own in high school, and I've played on one of my entire life. It never really stopped when I got on the show, because obviously we had to play basketball on the show. Yeah, you might see here.
When we came here and saw that car at the TRL, we were like, okay, people are watching our show.
All I want for Christmas is a wireless Guitar Hero 3 controller.
I love that.
That's all I want for Christmas.
Specific answer if I've ever heard.
Yeah, I live, you know, 3 miles from where, and on Paul, the same street as Paul.
Yep.
You know what that, I want that clock. That clock? You need to see the answer to that clock. It's like, it said 1207.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It tells if it's raining or cloudy or sunny.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Don't give away the air. The one thing that stays by. know if it's a
How do you do it? Is it adrenaline?
It's, I don't, yeah, it's gotta be. It's like a phenomenon because I'll be, they'll say cut and I'm like, just literally
like freezing,
and I like can't wait to get to my jacket. But when they say action and you're thinking, I guess, you know, you're thinking about what you say and what you feel in that moment, acting with somebody, communicating with somebody, it kind of goes away. Like, you literally,
I've always
don't
marveled
even think about this. And I don't know how it happens either, but I remember specifically there was a time, there was a scene where Nathan goes out and he's wearing
the picture at the beach.
And his mom comes in. Mm-hmm. And that scene, it was so cool. And he knew that scene. And it was just one of those times when it was physically impossible to say, not shivering. But somehow when they said rolling action, her and I were both completely fine.
Yeah, she was probably, I'm sure she was in a dress because it was the wedding.
Yeah. Oh, you she know? Was, you know, I'm sure she was in half as much. Half as many clothes as I was.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for 100 episodes. You know that we couldn't have done it without you. You guys have been there every step of the way supporting us.